This problem, we have f of x as square root of x square plus 1. Your goal is to find f prime.
Wait, is that general power rule? Oh, no, 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 no.
Okay, let me...
General power
rule. The, you said the general power rule?
Yeah.
Why you think about that rule?
Because it's like x square plus 1, it can be drawn like 1.5 power, right?
Okay, very good. Yep. Mm-hmm. So we're going to rewrite the square root in the form of the quantity x squared plus 1 raised to the power 1/2. Yes. And you can see that this is the quantity gx raised to the power n. And then the general power rule, when you find the derivative, just recall, is what would that be? Min, would you like to share with me what the general power rule? Based on the g to the power n.
Oh, so
the derivative of g to the power n would be
n minus oh
n
n this n g x n minus 1
n to the power n minus 1
and g prime
multiplied by g prime. Yep. Mm-hmm. And we use the same rule for our problem. In this case, the power is 1/2, and the g is your x squared plus 1. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
All right, you guys go ahead, put in the chat, what do you get for the first prime or the first derivative? So the f prime power is 1/2, the quantity gx is x squared plus 1, the power subtracted by 1 becomes negative 1/2, multiplied by g prime, so the gx is x squared plus 1, so then the g prime is 2x. So that's why we have to multiply on top of that by 2x. And then, yep, everything is correct. We apply the rule appropriately. The next step, we're going to simplify. Remember, if we simplify, we have to do it until we cannot simplify anymore. What would be the most simplified form for this problem?
Can I ask you some questions?
Okay. So this one, you see 2 and 2 here. Cancel. And then we have x, I write x in the front and multiply by x squared plus 1 to the power 1/2, negative sign. This is my first derivative. All right. So the next, what am I going to do to find the second derivative? How would I use the product rule? Okay. Very good. So I'm going to put the notes here. So we see the product.
Yeah.
We're going to use the product rule for the second derivative, sorry. The product rule, you identify the first one, the second one, I'm going to highlight. This is one term and this is another term, right? As a first and the second function. And then what we get based on the product rule, the first one multiplied by the derivative of the second one. The order doesn't matter. And then plus the derivative of the first one multiplied by the quantity of the second one. Right. So this step, we apply the product rule. And then go ahead, simplify it for me. What do you get?
I'm not sure that I'm right on this one.
So we have... x squared times the quantity negative. Okay, I think the sign is something that you still have to include. Okay, so let's work on this in detail. Thank you, Min. Mm-hmm. So what we have here, the second part, which is the derivative of x squared plus 1 to the power negative 1/2, you're going to have negative 1/2 multiplied by the quantity to the power negative 1/2 minus 1, which is negative 3 over 2 multiplied by 2x. Because in this case, the power is negative 1/2. Okay. And negative 3 half is from negative 1 half minus 1. All right, I do step by step. And then the derivative of x with respect to x, we get 1. X squared plus 1 to the power negative 1 half, no change. Then we're going to simplify x and x will be put together, but 2 and 2 here reduce with the negative sign. Okay, so then negative x and x becomes x squared, like what mean got. But recall the negative sign will be included for this portion. And the power of the first term is negative 3 over 2. Okay, and plus the second part, which is the quantity x squared plus 1 to the power negative 1 half. All right, we got the second derivative in the negative power form. So this part is good enough if you want to stop over here. But if the problem asks you to write in the positive power, I'm gonna write in different colors so to make it different. So the f double prime would be in the form of negative x squared divided by the quantity x squared plus 1 to the power 3 over 2, because when I write in the reciprocal, the power change to the opposite side. And also the second term. Okay. Now, if you want to make it into a more simplified form, you find a common denominator, which is x squared plus 1 to the power 3 over 2. What does it mean? You are going to multiply the second term by the extra factor to make up to be the same power, which is the power 1, because 1 plus 1 half, you get 3 over 2, which is the common power here. All right, so if you keep going, I mean, it's optional, it's not required. This one is good enough. If you keep going, this one is also good because the power of in the positive form. And then if you want to shrink them into one piece, you can also do that. Just another layer of the algebra skill that you have to bring it to the problem. So that means we have negative x squared plus the quantity x squared plus 1. How does it look? X squared and minus x squared take care of each other. And now the expression become 1 over the quantity x squared plus 1 raised to the power 3 half. And this is the most simplified form of the second derivative.